Hello children, today I am going to teach you grade 7, 7th lesson, Parallel Straight Lines. By studying this lesson, you will be able to identify parallel straight lines and how to draw parallel straight lines by using straight edge and your set square and the perpendicular distance between them and how to draw rectilinear plane figures by using straight edge and the set square. At the end of this lesson, I have given a small homework for you. If you find this video is helpful for you, don't forget to leave a comment and subscribe to the channel. Okay, shall we move to the lesson?
Before we start the lesson, we need to know about the difference between line and the line segment. Here you can see in a line there are two arrowheads at both ends. It means it has no endpoints. It extends both sides indefinitely. In a line segment, there you can identify two endpoints at both ends. Do you understand what I am saying? We can draw a line or the line segment using straight edge. Here you can see three types of lines. First one, intersecting lines. What is the meaning of intersecting? It means they meet at a point. Then these two lines are meet at a point. Second one, perpendicular lines. These two lines are also intersect at 90 degree angle. Third one, parallel lines. They are not meet at a point. In geometry, parallel lines are lines in a plane which do not meet. That is, two straight lines in a plane that do not intersect at any point are said to be parallel. There should be equal gap between these two lines. Okay, now we will see how to indicate the given lines are parallel to each other. Here we use two arrowheads and two slanted lines. Line segment AB is parallel to line segment CD. If you have given this type of diagram, you need to use arrowheads in two different ways. It means ABC lines are parallel to each other, as well as D and E lines are parallel to each other. But ABC lines are not parallel with D and E. That's why we use two different types of arrowheads. Now we will see how to draw a perpendicular to a given line. Here XY is the given line and you need to draw a perpendicular from the point P. Then you should keep your set square like this. Then after that you can draw a line from P to XY. Then PT is the perpendicular to XY. As the second step, I will explain how to draw a parallel line to a given line. Here we use two mathematical instruments, ruler and set square. XY is the given line. You should keep your set square on the XY line as shown here. Here I have drawn it using dotted lines. Then after that, you can move it towards the point P. If you draw a line through the point P, then that line will be parallel to XY. As the third step, I will explain how to draw rectilinear plane figures by using set square, ruler, and your pencil. Now we want to draw the rectangle ABCD whose length 8 cm and width 5 cm. This is the first step. You need to draw AB line segment by using ruler. The length should be 8 cm and you need to mark the two endpoints as A and B. Then after that, by using your set square, you can draw two perpendicular lines CB and DA like this way. Finally, you need to join point D to point C. Now I will give you a small homework. Here you need to draw PQRS parallelogram by using only your set square and ruler. Please leave the comment when it is done. As the last part of this lesson, you have to identify what are the instances you can observe this type of parallel edges. Here I have given three examples. You can identify more examples by observing your surroundings.